On this channel, I design IoT devices. But guess what? Every IoT device needs a server. So in today's video, we're focusing on a small yet powerful mini home server solution, the ZimaBoard. It features 4-core x86 architecture processor, so we can install almost any distribution and set up virtualization. Icewhale sent me the version with 8 GB of RAM and 32 GB of eMMC. One of these devices will be part of a giveaway. So don't forget to subscribe and leave a comment to enter the giveaway. I'm a big fan of passive cooling. This one comes with a robust, thick aluminum radiator, ensuring maintenance-free operation. On the right side, there's a PCIe 2.0x4 connector, a feature not commonly found in SBCs. The connector is open-ended, allowing for the installation of larger cards. What excites me the most is the possibility of connecting SATA SSD. It has not just one, but 2 SATA 6 gigabits per second ports. Although it comes with a single SATA cable, I've already ordered a Y-type cable for 2 SSDs, as I want to separate OS and data. On the front side, there are 2 LAN ports, alongside 2 USB 3.0 ports, a mini display, and a power supply port. Well, let's check what this server will offer to smart home users. This unit will serve as a home assistant server in a family member's apartment and as a remote backup server for me. ZimaBoard comes already installed with Casa OS, a streamlined and intuitive web UI, perfect for beginners in self-hosting and home automation. For configuration, simply connect to the local network and navigate to casaos.local and create a new user account. Before any further configuration, it's good practice to perform a distro update to ensure you have the latest and greatest. We're almost there. The only thing remaining is to change the Linux user password. The default username and password are CasaOS. To change the password, simply type passwd, hit enter, and follow the instructions. If we want to use an external SSD, we need to first format it. Remember, the SSD will be used for file hosting, but all containers we're going to install will be on the eMMC. In the App Store, we can find a bunch of pre-configured containers, like Node-RED, Plex, and PyHole. But I think we're all interested in Home Assistant, so let's install it and check how much CPU and RAM resources we have left. For a clean install, Casa OS with a desktop environment and Home Assistant together use 1.8 GB of RAM, which is okay, but I need more flexibility. So, I'm going to install Proxmox on the SSD. To prepare a bootable Proxmox USB flash drive, I use Balena Etcher. Then, I boot it like a regular PC by connecting a keyboard and display. First, I change the boot order in the BIOS, setting the first bootable device to USB and the second to the SSD. After that, I save the changes and reboot the ZimaBoard. The installation of Proxmox is straightforward. It's just a couple of clicks. First, choose the installation media. In my case, it's an SSD. The country is detected automatically. Then, enter a strong password, your real email, and the hostname. For me, the hostname doesn't end with .local, but is lab.lan. Finally, just click Next and install. That's all. After installing, open the web page using the address displayed on your screen. It will be different in your case. Accept the SSL certificate problem, as it's normal when we are in a local network, and enter the password you set during installation. Proxmox offers a slightly more complex experience, yet its flexibility and capabilities are outstandingly vast. In the Summary tab, we can monitor the extensive resources available for our use. Let's proceed to install the full Home Assistant OS, complete with add-ons. A community member has kindly developed a script that facilitates installation through a single command line. By default, this script allocates 2 cores and 4 GB of RAM. After installation, we have the option to reclaim some of these resources. Let's proceed with the installation by navigating to the IP address of the virtual machine. From this point forward, it becomes a standard Home Assistant setup. So, let's install a couple of add-ons so that the test is closer to the real scenario. I will be using ESP Home, File Editor, Node-RED, and maybe RTL 433 for door and window sensors. After restarting the Home Assistant OS with add-ons, it uses 2.5 GB of RAM out of 4, so we have plenty of memory left. Installing Proxmox solely for Home Assistant doesn't make sense. Instead, we can take advantage of Linux containers, which use very few resources because they do not virtualize the entire operating system. It's important not to confuse Linux containers with Docker containers, as we can install Docker containers within a Linux container. So, I am going to install two containers. One will be for Docker, where I'll host backup and file sharing applications. The second one will be for WireGuard VPN, which will connect ZimaBoard to my local network. To install a Linux container, you first need to download its image, which is a very easy process. Just select the container image you need and click Download. Now click Create CT and assign it a hostname and password. Click Next, then select the downloaded template. Allocate disk space. For WireGuard, 8 GB of disk space and 1 CPU core are enough. 0.5 GB of RAM is also sufficient. I want DHCP and will leave the DNS name blank. I will check Start after created so that it starts automatically and then finish. A clean install of one container uses 30 MB of RAM. To give you some perspective, one of the Linux containers on my main server, where I installed 11 Docker containers, uses only 1 GB of RAM. So, you can imagine how much more can be accomplished with such efficiency. From this, we can conclude that the ZimaBoard has sufficient resources for a wide range of home server applications. Together with Proxmox, the configuration options become limitless. I haven't even scratched the surface. We can do virtual switching, one-click backups and restoration, USB and PCI pass-through, not to mention clustering, which brings a whole new array of possibilities. The only downside I've noticed is that not all PCI devices can be connected without removing the metal bracket. And even when you can connect them, it ends up blocking the display port. In conclusion, if you are looking for a server with low power consumption, a compact footprint, and the capability to connect SSD or HDD disks, along with passive cooling, and you don't plan to run a large language model locally for a home assistant voice, it's a very good choice. Its passive cooling allows you to conveniently place it in a closet and forget about it. Last year was the year of the voice for home assistant, making voice control with cloud service a breeze. My aim is to spin up my own local AI for natural conversation and move beyond basic commands like turning the light on or off. But this requires a very powerful server. Icewhale has just started pre-orders for the ZimaCube Pro Creator. This server includes an A200 graphics card, which I think will be sufficient for running a local LLM. I'm wondering if Icewhale might let me borrow one. Congratulations to the winners of the previous video giveaway, and thanks for watching.